everyone. Today's lesson is on language awareness and is focusing on model verbs. This is a lesson which is taken from the Full Blast textbook for Form 4 students. Okay, first, let us look at what are model verbs. Model verbs are auxiliary verbs. They are used with other verbs to express ability, permission, obligation, possibility, giving advice, offering, and many more. Now, most model verbs have more than one meaning. They show functions such as urgency, possibility, determination, choice, or ability. Let's look at one example. You must see a doctor immediately. Here, the model verb must shows urgency or necessity. Here, the main verb is in the infinitive. Okay, let's look at the first set. May, might, or could. Tanya may, might, or could still be at home. Ring and see. So you can choose to use one of these three in the sentence and the sentence is still correct. I may not come to your sleepover on Sunday, but I'll let you know tomorrow. I might not come to your sleepover on Sunday, but I'll let you know tomorrow. Okay, now we use may, might, or could plus the infinitive without to express possibility in the present or future. Now, what is the meaning of possibility? Okay, that means there is a chance that it can happen or not. Okay, let's look at another example. He could be at home now. He may be at home now, or he might be at home now, right? We use may not or might not plus the infinitive without to express lack of possibility in the present or future. So there is a negative connotation in the sentence. We may not go to the party tonight, or we might not go to the party tonight. Okay, now let's look at must and can't. Okay, please remember can't is actually cannot and it is a single word. Danny hasn't eaten all day. He must be very hungry. Helen can't be at volleyball practice. She's got a broken leg. Let's listen to the explanation now. We use must plus the infinitive to express a positive deduction about the present or future. Now, what is the meaning of deduction? It is when you make a guess. So if the positive deduction is a deduction which is positive in nature. Okay, my parents must be at work now. Okay, the word now tells you that it's in the present tense. Okay, we use can't plus the infinitive without to express a negative deduction about the present or future. Okay, example, you can't be serious. Okay, there's a negative connotation to it and it's a negative deduction. Right? Okay, for must, have to, need to, or can't. Okay, for example, if you want to assemble those shelves correctly, you must read the instructions first. Okay, you can also use have to here. Okay, the second one, I need to borrow your jacket because mine is dirty. You mustn't touch anything in here. Look at the sign. You don't have to go to the shopping center to buy a mobile phone. You can order it online. Or you don't need to go to the shopping center to buy a mobile phone. You can order it online. Okay? Or you can also use needn't. You needn't go to the shopping center to buy a mobile phone. You can order it online. Here the explanation is, we use must plus the infinitive without to express personal obligation in the present. Now, what do you mean by obligation? Okay, when you say obligation, when you are supposed to do something, okay, you're obliged to do something, right? It can be a personal one coming from yourself. Right, so here the example is, I must finish this by tonight. Why? Because I say so. Right, So we use F to plus the infinitive without to express external obligation in the present. Now the obligation here comes from outside. It may be because it's a rule, or it's because something that someone says that we have to follow. Okay, for example, you have to drive on the left when you're in England. Or another example would be, you have to wear your uniform to school because it is the rule. So here it means it's the law, you have to follow, right? Okay, we use need to plus infinitive without to express necessity in the present or future. Okay, what do you mean by necessity? There's a need for something, we need to know something, we need to have the information in order to do something else. So here, example, I need to know how many people will be at the party. So in order to plan for the party, I need to know how many people will be there. Okay, so there's a necessity in knowing the answer. Right? Okay, mustn't and can't. We use mustn't or can't plus the infinitive without to express prohibition. Prohibition is when you are not allowed to do something. Okay, example, you mustn't park here, or you can't park here. That means you aren't allowed to. Right? Note here, you must remember, must and have to are used for the present. For the past and the future, we use the forms of have to, expressing either personal or external obligation. Example, when I was at school, I had to wake up at 7 o'clock every morning. Okay, or we'll have to work really hard to finish this project. Okay, I hope you understand all this. Okay, please read through your notes again if you don't understand, or ask your teacher for further explanation. Okay, now the last part for the first section is don't have to, don't need to, or needn't. We use don't have to or don't need to or needn't plus infinitive without to express lack of obligation or necessity in the present or future. Example, you don't have to call us again. That means it isn't necessary. Okay, she doesn't need to buy us presents. You needn't worry, everything is under control. Okay, here we use didn't have to, didn't need to, plus infinitive without to express absence of necessity in the past. Something wasn't necessary, but it's not clear if it was done or not. I didn't have to pick up the kids from school. Okay, or I didn't need to pick up the kids from school. Okay. Now, for this first section, you can refer to the grammar exercise on page 39 of the Full Blast Form 4 textbook for some practice. And you can check the answer with your teachers. Okay, let's go on to the next section. Okay, let's look at the second part of this grammar lesson, would rather. I would rather pay in cash than use my credit card. I'd rather not go shopping with you this Saturday, if that's okay. Would rather plus infinitive without to is used to express preference in the present or future. Preference is telling you about choice. Okay, it's usually followed by the word then, than. Okay, its negative form is would rather not. Okay, the examples here are, I'd rather listen to pop music than rock. I'd rather not have any salad, if that's okay. Okay, right, next, had better. We'd better go now, we're going to be late for this film. You had better not spend all your money on computer games. Your parents will get angry. We use had better plus infinitive without to give strong advice. It often expresses threat or warning, and it's stronger than should or ought to. It refers to the present or future, not the past. Its negative form is had better not. Alright, so here you better ask a doctor about it. You better not lie to me again. So the word here gives you a clear idea that it's a warning or a threat. Alright, and it's often more There's an emphasis to it, all right? A strong advice, okay? Okay, let's look at should or ought to. You should buy this jumper. It's a great bargain and it suits you. You ought to buy this jumper. It's a great bargain and it suits you. You shouldn't take your sister's things without asking. You ought not to take your sister's things without asking. Now, should or shouldn't plus infinitive without to refers to the present or future and is used for, okay, first, to ask for or give advice. Should I apologize to John for shouting at him? You shouldn't eat so much sugar. Or second, to make a suggestion, you should be more careful when you drive. Or third, to express mild obligation, you should go to work on time. Okay, for the second section of the notes and examples, you can also look at your textbook at page 41 to do the exercise on grammar for further practice. Okay, we have come to the end of the lesson. I hope you have understood the explanation that I have given. If you need any more explanation or clarification, please do refer to your English teacher. And please do try the exercises to understand better. I'll see you in another video. Thank you.